You ready? I'm sitting here with the album. I'm all ready. It's already on the turntable. We are talking about Clutch. If you can read it, that is. Or it doesn't matter. I just said it, and it is in the title, as the two tracks will be in the description, you know, down below. Clutch. I'm just gonna, so you can see it, Blast Tyrant, double LP, yes, sirree, Bob. And we will, first of all, welcome back. It's about time we do some more Clutch. I only touched on the, I made one video concerning Clutch before this one, a year ago or two maybe. That was, as I remember it, it was three songs from the album Earth Rocker. This time we are also taking it's not the newest Clutch album, it's a older one, and I also think, without saying too much, I can say it's one of the popular ones, but they got more than two popular albums. They got lots. I would say 70 or 80% maybe of the catalog is very popular amongst fans. They rarely make an album that's a boo-boo, a direct boo-boo, you know. They have a real good, consistent track record. I often compare them with the Fu Manchu. In many ways, it's mostly awesome. It's like 80 or 90% awesome, all of it. But then you have one or two or maybe three albums that's like, I don't know, out of 15 or, you know, around. I haven't count how many albums we're talking about studio. Clutch is way over 10. So is Fu Manchu. So anywho, also a thing that is very common, or you know, shared between the two groups, it kind of sits also in stoner rock and space rock, from, not in every track, but you know, the inspiration is really heavy on Black Sabbath and stuff like that, you know, original stoner, and you can say garage rock, and maybe even some punk rock influence in the early days, also on both groups. But in this video we will concentrate on Clutch, and it's about time. Long story short, it's about time, because I think they are very important to shine a light on, because they're just fucking awesome. That's the short story. They really rock. That is, and we're gonna start it very soon, because why not just jump into it, and then we can talk about it. I picked out these two tracks because these are one of those I have been listening to most. They are very hard to stop listening to, I would say. It's you can even dance to this music if you like that stuff. Not every track, but most of them, I guess. It's very danceable, you know. And it's just fucking groovy and funky, and you'll see if you don't know, but I guess people watching this video, most of them know that's how it usually works. Fans looking for stuff they love, you know? Yeah. Let me just announce the first one is Prophets of Doom. And then we will take after that The Mob Goes Wild. And I think we should fucking go. The needle is already down. I'm just gonna remove something. And yeah, let's see how it goes. Prophets of Doom. Yeah. With some attitude. Almost something about a white man and a black man, or did I hear it wrong? It doesn't matter, because it was all about, for me anyways, about how funky this track is. And boy do I love it when he, and it's the singer who writes the lyrics mostly, as far as I know, are drawing in, tell me who's that writing, John the Revelator, tell me who's that song, you know, I really love that song, and it's also in Blues Brothers 2000. You know, and it just keeps on escalating. The revelation of Jesus. My God, you know that one? Just go back and listen to it. I should almost have a video about that number. I love that number. And so it couldn't put a bigger smile on my face when I heard this the first time, and it was like, damn, that's tight. That's also, I don't know, is it just me? I think there's a lot of humor in the text. All of a sudden, he switch over to a literally joke about two guys walking into a bar. One guy said to the other, you know, a classic joke setup. And also put that in the lyric. It's fantastical. Fe no fucking menale. You got something again? Excuse me. So now I hope you can see why I chose this one. If we're gonna do Clutch right, we better go back. And I could go back to the first, but honestly, I have not. It's not in my possession. I don't own the first album. This is one of the oldest in my collection, as far as I know. So, yeah, Blast Tyrant. It's fantastic. Next one is The Mob Goes Wild. I think that's even a bigger fan favorite. I'm not sure, but I think so. I really dig it. I'm not saying I think I have a special place for this one because we just heard only because of that lyric that says, you know, John the Revelator, tell me who's that writing, you know. Let's go, man.
Please allow me to adjust my pants. Please allow me to dance the good time dance. And put the onlookers and innocent bystanders into a trance.
That's a funny lyric.
Fire!
Chill, or what you call it. Started the next. That's just, they are just playing to a party, you know what I mean? It's like, it's very clear, it's good old fun rock and roll. The spirit of, as I said, Fu Manchu and even AC/DC, I was about to say. But if I had to choose, just for the fun of it, it's an easy pick. I would rather listen to Clutch than AC/DC. That's easy for me to pick. So yeah, you see what I mean when I say, if this is not rock and roll, I don't know what rock and roll is. If it's not, you know, awesome shit, I could also say, if this is not cool as fuck, I have no taste. I have so much confidence in my opinion on Clutch that I'm willing to put my reputation on the line on this band. If this is proven to be crap in the long run, I would eat my head, literally. And I'm not afraid of that happening, because I trust my taste when I say this is some of the best fucking rock and roll you will ever hear. Period. I'm deciding that right now on my channel. That is the official opinion on my channel. That's not spoken too much. You know, in the words of Lebowski, it's just like your opinion, man. But I am the Lebowski right now, and I'm saying, you know, the older Lebowski. And I'm saying new shit has come to light. Or was it? That was also Jeff who said that. New shit has come to light. It's not new, but you know what I mean? If it is new to you, it fits the bill. Your life will immediately get better from now on, knowing there's a group called Clutch. Go get it. It's fantastic. And trust me, they rarely, just start with the most praised ones. You know, this album is fantastic from start to finish. Blast Tyrant. But as I might say it earlier, 80% of the catalog is stellar. It's like Fu Manchu. It's not prog rock we're listening to. If you have the first Clutch album and the latest, they are not miles away from each other. Some progress or stuff has happened, and you can hear that. But it's almost like Fu Manchu, you know. Or some other bands who are very consistent, like AC/DC. And lots more, you know. So yeah, man. I don't think there's much more to say about this at this point, other than that was just fucking awesome. These two tracks are some of the most played Clutch tracks in my living room. Everybody I know has heard these two in a row. and lots of other, you know, many other songs from Clutch. If we are talking and concentrating only on Clutch right now, and we are, so yeah, all my peeps definitely are in the know. And I don't have to say, it's not a surprise, I guess, even for you, that of course I'm the biggest Clutch fan in my circle. As you might guessed, sitting here with the LPs and stuff, you know, making videos about them, talking them up in the clouds, sitting right next to the great ones, you know, definitely, in my opinion, that's a easy Rock and Roll Hall of Fame entry. Long time ago. Tell me who's that right? John the Revelator. Tell me who's that right? John the Revelator. Tell me. I love that song. I freaking love it. So now I shared it with you. And I know it's not, it wasn't a cover of that song, but it's just perfect to just like mention it. It's like a cameo, but in music, you know, a little Easter egg. Again, it was a film, it's cool. I dig it. I also have to say, if I had not said before, I'm a huge Blues Brothers fan, especially the soundtrack. And see, perfetto. Clutch, thank you very much for including John the Revelator. You know, thank you. Jesus, my God, my God. So yeah, without further ado, I will bid you goodbye and domo ragazzo. Thank you very much, Room, and yeah, man. Next video will be video number 300. That's crazy. Yeah. This was 299. Not kidding. 300. I think that's a lot of videos. But we just got started, I think, also. So hang on. And did I say goodbye? I think I did. And yeah, all that stuff. Until next time, it will be very interesting. What is video number 300? It just dawned on me. That should be special. What can you do? Make a reaction to the 300 soundtrack. That's dumb. You're not gonna do that. So, yeah, man, I said goodbye, sun is shining, it's a weekend, as I said, you know I love you, until next time, have a fantastic day, and may the sun always shine on you and your loved ones. Hi.